Yo, what's good, YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ. And make sure you hit that like button. We're back for this Harvard legacy, and we are in the still beginning parts of this season, sitting here at 6-5. But we do run into some old friends over at San Jose State. We actually lose 82-71, and we are actually at home during that game. And so we go up against a really good Florida State team next, sitting here at 6-6, and we're going to need to put together some wins here if we want to start out this conference play right. So we do get in the gym here with Jamal Patterson with some rebounding work there, and Jameel Aziz working on his mid-game. And here's the thing, you know, a lot of games have not gone our way because we don't really close, and that's kind of what I want to focus on. That's why I want to work on the mid-range, getting some jump shots and getting some easy bonus workout points in areas that, you know, are little things in the game, not the big three-pointers, not working on stuff like that. So we want to get that going. So here we go, hopping into this Florida State action here at home to open conference play. Here is AJ Starr with a deep three to start it out, and we make it our first three-pointer of the game. But here's some early momentum from Florida State coming into conference play. They are pumped up. There is Baye there on the assist. Here is Mann shooting from three, and he's hitting that one. And they've jumped out to our early 11-3 lead. And here with the six-point lead, dropping it into Jang, and he's going to lay it in for the and one, and Florida State is going to take the 9-point lead. So here in a 14-5 game, here is Braden Sexton taking it all the way, and the senior doesn't get that one to go, but he does convert from the line. So here in an 18-9 game, here is Jameel Aziz getting fouled, as that's how we got to get going in this game, getting fouled, going to the bucket. So now in a 20-11 game, passing out to a wide open Aziz is Loving Good, and he's going to hit a three, and that's going to make it a six-point game. So now as this first quarter does wind down here with 7 minutes left, here is Juice Harrison from the outside off of the bench, and he's getting it back down to a three-point lead. So here in transition, here's Braden Sexton taking it to the lane. He's going to miss the wide-open layup, and we got to convert those if we're going to stay in these games with teams that are better. So here's Jang on the offensive boards. He's laying it up and in, and he's making it a five-point lead for Florida State. So now in transition, Braden Sexton taking it to the lane. And I really like Braden Sexton's ability to drive the lane, shoot the three. He can kind of do it all at the point guard position. So here is another offensive board that time by Jang, and he's landing in and making it a five-point lead. So here is Baye on the offensive boards as well. He's a big center, and he gets an offensive board and lays it in for another easy layup. So here's Lionel Shorts getting going off the bench. He gets 2 points inside the lane. So now in a 28-21 game, here's Leonidas on the offensive boards, laying it in as we put him in to kind of match up with their size with Baye in the middle. So here's Lionel Shorts off of a steal, driving the lane, and he's going to boom that one and convert on the fast break dunk over Jang, and that's going to spark this team off the bench. And our bench is actually really deep. We go about 10 deep in a game, and we want to continue to do that because we don't have many superstars. We don't have guys that can take the pressure off in games. I think Aziz can possibly be that guy, but we don't have kind of a guy that can just take over a game right now. So here's Lionel Shorts, another big dunk, as he is coming off the bench and providing a little bit of a spark that we really desperately need in this game, because Florida State is owning the boards in this one as they have the 5-point lead as his first half winds down. So here on the defense, you see that time getting a block on Loving Good, and this time Ramsey hits the deep three, and he's got 7 points to end this half as we actually go into halftime down by 5 points. Not too bad. I mean, they were playing good D. They're getting a whole lot of offensive rebounds. As you see, they're out-rebounding us 16-7, double our rebounds. And we actually are forcing some turnovers, but they're just killing us on the board. So this is definitely something that we got to address going into the second half. You see, our starting lineup only has one board each. Look at that, all the way through. And look at them. I mean, 11 points. I mean, they're just killing us. So here to start the second half, you see they're starting out with some defense. Here's Ramsey on the fast break, passing up to Hipster, and he's getting his first two buckets of the game. So here's Falkering on the layup and somehow blows that. I don't know how he missed that, but it converts into Ramsey the other way, and he's getting an and one from Sexton. And there they go, Florida State taking the 10-point lead. But Braden Sexton does come back out on offense, taking it to the lane, and he's got some dribble moves, and he makes it back to a single-digit lead. But Ramsey firing back on offense, hitting the three. He's their best shooter, and he makes it a double-digit lead right back. But here's Gusko on the three-pointer on the outside, assisted by Baye. We got to watch Baye because he is a great offensive rebounder for Florida State. So we do end up cutting this lead down to 8 as there's 10 minutes left here in the second half. Here's Gusko passing it back out to Mann. He's going to hit the deep three, and Mann's got 14 points as they are spreading this ball around. As you see Ramsey on the outside, one more open shot. Misses, but Baye is there on the rebound, and they are just killing us on the boards as they've continued to have this double-digit lead here in the second half. But coming off a steal, here's Jang laying it up, but he's another rebound, and he's laying it up again, and that's another offensive board that converts into points as they just continue to dominate here in the second half. You can see they are just killing us here. Schultz at point guard laying it up, and he's getting another miss, but look at this, another offensive rebound, that time by Baye. And now this lead is going to keep up in double digits as here's Ramsey taking it to the rim. And that's going to be all she wrote in this one. 13-point game there for Florida State. They shoot 41%. We didn't shoot that much worse, but the offensive rebounds were just killing us in this one. You see they had 27. They had 12 offensive rebounds. And I believe that 10 of those offensive rebounds actually converted into points. So you see Braden Sexton had a pretty good game at point guard. I actually like him that he's all around. He's not just doing one thing. AJ Starr only shot 2 of 7, but I like that we didn't have a guy with double digit shot attempts because that lets us know that we're moving the ball. But we have to play some good defense. We have to get more rebounds there because, man, they just killed us in that game. So we do move to 7-7 as we do go on to play Georgia. And we actually beat Georgia, which is actually really surprising, but we did upset them. AJ Starr had 11 points, but he shot 4 of 12. AJ Starr is not off to the start that I thought he would get, and it's kind of hurting us a little bit as we want him to be more consistent. So here we are going into this game on the road, our second ACC game of the season, as we go on the road to Coral Gables to play Miami and Chris Likes at point guard. He's a little guy. I believe he's only 5'7", but he can shoot. He can play. So here we go into this matchup, and we want to kind of take control early and play some good defense. So coming off of the first shot of the game, that one's missed by Likes as we come back out on defense. Braden Sexton on the rebound here, pushing the ball up the floor, passing it out to Aziz for the mid-range, and that's exactly what we were working on as he makes it a 2-0 lead to start this game. So now here is Sexton for his second early rebound, passing it up this time to Jamal Patterson. He's taking it to the lane and making it a 4-0 lead. So we continue this hot start here, giving it up to Falkering in the post, and he's laying it off the glass for the baby hook. And he starts it out 6-0. So here's Falkering in the post this time, has Likes mixed, matched up on him, and he passes it out to AJ Starr for the three. So now in a 9-4 game, Braden Sexton at the top of the three-point line. He's driving it in, and he's making it an 11-4 lead. So now here playing some defense. There's Sexton. Like I said in the last game, he can do it all. He's driving on that one on the fast break dunk and making it an 8-point lead here on the road. So now here with the full court press is Miami. But here is Dorsey laying it up and in, and he's getting an and one. That's a foul on Lawrence. And here we go. This Harvard team starts out hot. Leonidas in the game now in a 16-5 lead. Passing up to AJ Starr. AJ Starr is going to shoot this one in traffic. He's going to get that one to go. And now it's a 13-point lead. So now here still with a double-digit lead. Here is Dorsey on the inside, assisted from Sexton, and he gets 2 points. But here's Sexton on the steal once again, back to Dorsey for back-to-back steals and another fast break point. So now here we go, 13-point lead. Here's Leonidas from Sexton. He's laying it up, and we have a 15-point lead here to start this game. It's Jameel Aziz's turn this time, taking it to the lane. He scored the first 2 points of the game. Those are his first points since that time, as he has 4 points here towards the end of the first half. So here is Lee on the rebound, passing up to Aziz. Aziz to Giordano. He's going to lay it in on the fast break, and it's a 19-point lead. So here is Chris Likes passing it out to Hale. Hale's going to miss on the three-pointer. Juice Harrison off the bench. Here's giving it up to Jameel Aziz. He's going to take it in, and that's a 21-point lead here in the first half. As who saw this coming, as we have our biggest lead of the entire season. But Miami does start to come back towards the end of the first half here with under 6 seconds left. Here is Gibson from the line, passing it into Hale, and Hale's going to lay it in on the assist from Terry. And they do come back and trim down this lead to 12, but what a start for Harvard as we go into halftime with this 12-point lead, shooting 55%. And Coral Gables, Miami, is only shooting 34. That's a huge difference, as if we can keep playing this defense, we can hold on and get our first conference victory of the season. So here we go. Let's hop into this second half here. As you see, Braden Sexton is on his way to a triple-double, it looks like. And here we go. Chris Likes matched up on Jameel Aziz, getting posted up. And Jameel Aziz with the Kobe fadeaway. He's got 9. So now here's Gibson from the top of the three-point line, passing it out to Mackinson. Mackinson's going to pass it back out to Gibson, and Gibson's going to hit the deep two. And that makes it a 10-point lead. So here's Jameel Aziz from the three-point line, posting up, going to pass it out to a wide-open AJ Starr on the other corner. And that's going to be a 3 for who's supposed to be our leading scorer of the team. So now here is Everton on the inside with the baby hook, and he's getting that in. And that's going to be a 12-point lead for Harvard. So now here is Likes passing it into Hale. Hale's going to lay it up. And Hale's got 12 points silently, as he's actually doing a really good job on the offensive end. So here is Likes on the press. Here shooting a deep three. He shoots that one in traffic. How did he hit that? And he's only got 5 points, but he is probably their best rated player on their team. So here is Miami making their way back into this game, now down by 7. Here's Jameel Aziz, though, taking it to the lane, and somehow Jameel Aziz loses the ball, as I don't know what happened on that. Chris Likes is too small to even get up there, but he loses it. But here is Gary on the three-point shot, and this lead is down to just 4. Here's Aziz backing up. Now passing out to Juice Harrison, missing the deep two, and look at this, these missed shots are opening up opportunities for them to come back. So here's Hale passing it into Kent, and he's laying it up and in, and it's now a 2-point lead. Wow, and we had to call a timeout there to stop this momentum. So now here with a 2-point lead, here's Braden Sexton taking it to the lane, and he's laying it off the backboard, making it a 4-point lead. But here's Falkering on the steal, laying it up and in. He can't hit it. Wow, from in close, we got to hit these easy shots. So now down the stretch, under 7 minutes left. Here is Gary at the top of the three-point line, passing it to Terry this time. And he's going to take a deep three. And now it is just a 1-point game. So now Leonidas backing down, passing out to a wide-open Aziz. He can't hit the shot. As, man, here we go. But here is Hale pushing it up the court, passing it over to Terry again, and he's going to hit his second three in a row, and Miami, just like that, comes all the way back and takes the lead. So here is Kent passing it back out to Terry, another three, and man, is he on fire as he comes off the bench hitting three threes And now they have the 5-point lead. Now here is Aziz after a turnover here after the block, passing it into Lovinga. Lovinga's going to miss. Aziz gets the rebound. He's going to miss. Lovinga pump fakes, lays it back up and in, and we finally get a bucket. As this is kind of the half it's been, we've been missing all kinds of shots. Here's Gibson driving into the lane. An easy layup. Where is the D on that one? So now with the 5-point lead, Miami comes all the way back. But look at Braden Sexton trying to carry this team back as he's been probably our best player in this game. Here is Sexton driving to the lane once again, and he's making it a 1-point lead. So now 3 minutes left here in this second half. Here is a pass inside to Everson. Everson is going to lay it up and in, and that makes it a 3-point game here with 2.5 minutes left. So now pass inside to Everson. This time he's going to miss, but he's going to get his own rebound, and somehow that ball rims out, and he grabs his own offensive board and lays it up as they now take the 5-point lead. So now here's Miami. Back out after a block. Gibson missing the three. Everson gets a rebound, and he's going to lay it up. And wow, he's got 5 offensive rebounds all in the second half. So now here is Jameel Aziz. Open three. He trims it to 4 with that three as he's got 12. But it might be a little too late here as Miami. Here's Chris Likes missing the open three. And Lawrence gets the offensive rebound. And that's an and one. And wow, this time runs down to under a minute left, and we just cannot recover from those threes and that momentum and those offensive rebounds, as here is Miami. They eventually take this lead and do not give it back as they go on to win this game. Down by 21 at one point, win it by 11. What a game from Everson. And wow, I mean, it was just insane. That second half, they were just getting all the rebounds. They were hitting all the shots. And we just could not recover as Everson had a double-double. 12 and 11. Gibson had 11 points as well. Terry had 11 points off the bench. 3 huge threes. And it just could not get any worse for us there in that second half. Hale had 12 points off the bench and 5 rebounds. I mean, just a bad defensive second half from this Harvard team. We got a lot of room to grow, but Braden Sexton did have a double-double in points and rebounds. It's actually really surprising. 12 rebounds from the point guard position. He had a good game, but we just did not finish there in the second half. And Braden Sexton actually finished 5 of 19 shooting. I mean, that's not good. He went 0 of 4 from deep. So we definitely want to improve here as we move into conference play. We had a couple of tough matchups to start out. One versus Florida State, both in the state of Florida, Miami too. So we got to recover here. So hit subscribe, hit that like button. You don't want to miss any of this action. We're going to hop into conference play, ACC action. So stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go.